Hey, when it comes to losing weight, do you find that one of the struggles that you always find time and time again is that you can't seem to plan meals? You can't plan out what you're going to have ahead of time and make it work. You're always at the mercy of having to buy things on the go, and that's leading you to make choices that you know aren't in your best interest. Well, in today's video, that's exactly what I want to talk to you about and show you some strategies that could really, really turn things around for you and make it a lot more simple. So what tends to happen is most of the time when people hear planning meals ahead of time, they instantly jump from one extreme to the next. And I wanna show you what that looks like. So think about it like a big continuum, all right? So there's this line that we've got going on here. Now at the moment, if you don't plan any meals, let's just say you're at level one. So this is, you have no plan whatsoever. You're just literally buying things on the go when you get a signal from your body that, hey, I need something to eat, okay? And then right up the other end at level 10, this is where you've got like every Sunday, you're spending hours preparing everything ahead of time. You're cooking your food, it's all organic. You're putting it into really small containers and you've got 7 days worth of, you know, 3 square meals a day, already packaged, ready to go. So that's the extreme end, right? Most people, when they think about planning meals, they picture themselves going from here to here in one big hit. You know, just going straight overnight, hey, I'm gonna get this meal prep thing down pat. I'm gonna be a master meal prepper. I'm gonna have everything in little containers and it's all gonna happen on Sunday. In reality, it doesn't work like that. Most people get discouraged. They try and jump from one extreme to the next, and what tends to happen is it's too hard, they've changed too many things too drastically, too quickly, and they just go straight back to level one. If that feels like what's happening for you, this will be really helpful. So what we want to try and do, instead of going from one extreme to the next, is go in small increments. We want to go from level one to level two, then to level three, and work our way up and get to a point where we feel comfortable. You know, level 10 might not be something that you need to do. You don't need to have everything in small little containers and be spending hours and hours in the kitchen. If not, that's cool. Like, you know, get to a level where you're comfortable with and stay there. If it's serving you in a better way, that's going to be where you stop. So how do we actually go from level one and we start working our way up in small increments? Well, there's a couple of strategies I want to go over. So optimize first, all right? We want to be looking at what are you eating already? So pick out the meals that you're eating. Maybe you're eating, say, let's say 3 square meals a day. So you're having breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Go through and sort of just make a tally or a list of what you're actually eating, and then how can you optimize those meals even further? So can we include fruit and vegetables in there? Can we try to do that across one meal for every day and then work our way up to doing it for each meal every single day? So if we're having our 3 meals a day, we might start with breakfast. How can I include vegetables in breakfast for each day? Don't worry about everything else just yet, just focus on one meal. And then we're going to start to optimize that meal further and further. Like, how can I make these better? You know, what can I include into this meal to make it more nutritious, to give my body what it actually needs? So that would be step one. We want to optimize first what we're already doing. We don't want to change too drastically because that's just going to send us backwards and we're going to go right back to the start here. That brings me to the next point. Include before you exclude. All right, this is really simple. We want to think about it a lot of the times. When we're talking to clients, they automatically say to us, you know, what foods do I need to cut out? Let's try flip that around and let's go, what can you include first before you take anything out? So it goes back to the whole thing of eating vegetables. Everyone knows vegetables are really good for them. They know that fruits and veggies, you know, you were told as a kid that these are good for you. Let's start trying to include as many of those as we can. And a crazy thing's gonna happen. Through natural attrition, you're going to start to eat less of the bad food that you consider, and while you're increasing the quality of the food that you're actually eating, so the nutritional value of that. Include before exclude. And the third one, we want to make it easier, okay? So like I said earlier, we want to start with one meal at a time. Don't go from prepping nothing to trying to prep everything and get it all spot on and, you know, 100% accurate. We want to just start with one meal at a time. What I like to do personally is pick the hardest meal. What's the one meal that is probably the most frustrating for you? And really try to plan that first. Do the hardest thing first, and then everything else is going to be easier for you to do. So pick out the the one meal that really causes you the most grief. Maybe it's breakfast, maybe it might even be dinners. Have a bit of a schedule going with dinner and look to, again, optimize the meal first. Then we want to include before we exclude, and then start to make it easier. Then we can think about, all right, what am I going to have 2, 3, 4 days from now, and then start looking at preparing that. Once you've got one meal done for the week and you know it's all working out for you and everything's going well, then start looking at the next meal. But again, we want to go in small increments. We don't want to just try and go from 1 to 10 straight away. That's just going to send us backwards. So that's a really easy way to start down this road. I know it's going to take a little while to obviously get the habit of this going and to actually put this into practice. But if you follow those simple strategies that are laid out, it's going to make it a lot easier for you.